And it looked nice. He set his gun down next to the tree and he walked around and looked at this opening because it just seemed like an opening in the middle of the woods. And while he was walking around, he fell into an open well. Mm-hmm. He was down in that well. And the water was up about to his waist. And he couldn't get out the well because he couldn't get a grip on the sides to climb out. It was too slick. And after he had worn himself out praying and shouting, "Help, help," he stopped and leaned over against the side of the wall of the well. He began to remember his life. Mm-hmm. And he remembered when he was a boy, he used to go to Sunday school. And when he went to Sunday school, he remembered some of the songs that he used to sing and how good he would feel in church. And he started singing those songs. And while he was singing those songs, the Holy Ghost came upon him. He lit up with the fire of the Holy Ghost. And he started singing louder and rejoicing in the Lord. While he was rejoicing and singing louder, there were some more men out hunting, and they heard him, and they came over, and they looked at him. "Are you okay?" "Oh, I'm wonderful. I'm blessed. And you are too." They said, "Well, let us get a rope. We'll get you out the hole." They went and got the rope, and they pulled him up out of the hole. And he began to preach. And every person that he found that was a candidate for the Holy Spirit, he would throw them in that hole. How many of us, in our understanding, are standing in the way of God's word because it's just not the way it happened with me? God is not locked up on your way. You've got to be open to the many wondrous things that God is about to do. And in being open to those things, you will find a place that will keep you away from sin and degradation. There you'll find even more so what this scripture says. Oh, take courage. God is with you. I know it may seem rough. I know the cross hurts. But God is with you. Work. Keep working. Don't stop, as it says here. And in closing, we talk about the glory. It says in the sixth verse, "For thus says the Lord of hosts," once again, I don't know if you've fallen away or you're having a Holy Ghost meeting at this time, but once again it says, "in a little while." And I just love that phrase, because Jesus told his disciples when he was going to the cross, "In a little while, you'll look for me, and you won't be able to find me.
All right.
Oh, your hearts will be heavy, full of sorrow. You'll feel like the whole world and all the universe is about to end. But take courage.
Yes, sir.
I'm with you.
Yes.
Even until the end.
Yes, sir.
Our God takes an earth-shaking body like yours and mine and the situation that we have, and he shakes it up, heaven and earth, but he will bring to us what we need. I can witness to that.
Yes, sir.
He'll bring to us what we need and strengthen us in his holiness. And in that marriage in which will take us to a time in which there will be no more crying.
Yes.
No more sorrow. Joy.
praising the Lord.
Amen.
God bless you.